Okay, so my name is Kasper Kempinski. I'm here as as part of Foundation Institute of Architecture in Krakow. But since I'm working now in National Institute for Architecture and Urban Planning in Warsaw, it might be a little bit confusing. And similarly to the Czech Republic, one of the key investors in Poland during the times of crisis in '90s was the state-owned bank PKO BP, which built dozens of buildings across the country. But what is interesting in ZUS, the social insurance institution, it's that it was the first institution which built unintentionally a consistent, recognizable aesthetic all over the Poland. And as I feel that postmodernist architecture and architectural dimension of transformation in Poland is usually analyzed in the context of iconic buildings, whether they good or not, and built in big cities, and big cities means mostly Warsaw. This is because this is where the biggest hotels and offices and bank offices were located. The architectural landscape of the provincial small towns and villages were shaped by the churches, which we have seen before, and individual housing, which bloomed after the 89, and finally by ZUS branches in the towns of all the regions of Poland. And to give you some context, the ZUS was established in 1934 and has a great history and great architectural legacy. And from the very beginning, they were investing money not only in the headquarters, not only in the offices, but also in the housing. During the interwar period, the very top architects of Poland were designing the housing estates in completely modern modern aesthetics, modern typology. After the Second World War, ZUS was closed in 55 and reopened in 60. And as with the new borders, new administrative division of the country, ZUS had to also reshaped itself. And from the time of the People's Republic of Poland, there are few examples of the ZUS buildings which are mostly kept in the modernist aesthetics and have there was no like coherent one image of the ZUS building. They were just the typical offices. But it started changing in late 80s, and with new postmodernist typology, and as the 90s 90s brought us the transformation transformation of the economics and transformation of insurance system, they started they needed to start build new infrastructure for completely new system. They were forced to create like more than 10 million of individual account and completely new IT system, which they never had. So for these purposes, they started building the branches across the country. And what is important, we there are more than 30 buildings built, and there was no they were designed all by the different architects to look into the data, the information about the architects is very difficult, as a lot of them are ashamed part of the legacy of these architects, and then Most of them are built in the system of the lowest cost possible, where general contractor chooses its own architects. And in this special case, it's also interesting that they still kept the one image in all of these big and smaller cities. Here we have the ZUS headquarters in Szczecin from 96, and which is one of the biggest regional headquarters. However, they started building another one in this city, and because of this aesthetics, we'll see in all of the examples, they're using the green reflective glass, the green walls which are connected with the branding, the shiny golden frames, and then it is transformed to interiors. But what I said before, and it's the most important part in analyzing the whole transformation context of the country, that this was the process that was that covered all the area of Poland. It wasn't only for the biggest cities like with hotels and offices in Warsaw or in Wrocław, but also like small cities like Jelenia Góra or all the lower administrative cities got some ZUSes there, and this is the one of the most recognizable examples. And they got by the public opinion, they got the nickname of ZUS palaces as a whole thing. They are highly recognizable across the country as the ZUS palaces, and as ZUS itself explains, and they never tried to go beyond building new infrastructure. The main purpose was to create just the better conditions for the clients, which is not understood by the clients. But then we will. If you go into the to the interviews with spokespeople from ZUS, they always emphasize that the highest quality of the space and the best conditions were always in the client service areas, and they're trying to explain that the offices for the workers were not air conditioned, and the only air conditioning rooms were for the clients, and except the management areas, and aesthetics was just a coincidence. But this coincidence, it's similar everywhere. The only one which goes outside this aesthetics is ZUS in Zabrze, which is also from the same time, but completely in different typology. Also, there is one in Gdańsk, which is in the old town, and its architecture is more as a reinterpretation of the old town architecture. And as I told you before, the scale of the construction of ZUSes is huge. Sometimes there are big buildings, tower blocks, and costly buildings in big cities, but you will find these buildings everywhere in small cities of 20,000 people, and they are always highly recognizable, even if it wasn't intended. And the change came in 2000s somehow again. It wasn't planned at all, and there is a visible change in the aesthetics of ZUS's building, and from the shiny postmodernist international style of the 80s, they moved towards the colonnades and the more institutional like look, building the image of the stable institution. And the main headquarters is the main, also main example of this part of Zeus legacy, because it was it is situated in between two graveyards in Warsaw on the plan of Eagle, and surrounded by the underground parkings which protects their clients to enter the building. Then we have fences, the CCTV cameras everywhere, and so on and so on. And the biggest CEO offices in the public institutions in Poland. So it was also seen as a huge waste of public funds. Again, the way of explaining this construction was the IT system which was created, and the defense institutions were didn't want to keep them in old buildings not protected enough. And this kind of brownish steel columns and brown reflective glass buildings are also still being built, because it's they had this one first phase of the greenish phase, and now they entered the beige phase, and it's still there. You can see the, I showed you before this cubic form from Kielce. They started building it in the 70s and ended up in 94. And this is a new building of Zeus in Kielce on the right, and almost completely new in Łódź. And there are no competitions for these buildings. As I told you, it's all up to general contractor and interiors, as the main purpose of creating all these buildings is, of course, the comfort of us. The most recognizable part and the most design part is the client service areas, and again, they all look the same, where we have this huge waiting area in the middle, green and brown furniture, and prison-like interviewing spaces next to each other, and of course in the flowers. And public opinion about this is, as I told you, they are seen as a Zeus palaces, and the Zeus palaces are seen as a reason of having not enough money for the insurances, but they always assure that there are two separate funds for it. Anyway, as you can see on the right bottom, is already started being some kind of phenomena in Poland in architectural way. This is like mainstream website about architecture, showing the different examples of Zeus buildings. There is also an artistic response to that by collective Rozdzielczość Chleba from Krakow, and the Zeus Wave website, where they investigate not only the aesthetics or the architecture, but also the social aspects, like the here we have Lublin, so you things. And then again, the interiors, which are also this is also interesting how they digitalize everything, because digitalization of Zeus space it's happening, because all the tools you can use online, like making some papers and so on, are designed as a space of Zeus. And this one I can play. So this is from Zeus website, and you can use Zeusomat as it is in the real life. So this is also kind of architecture which goes beyond architecture into the internet. And the music is also made from so. So this, to sum up these few images, as you can see, it's not yet the research. It's more like proposals we, together with Alice Jakzowska in National Institute of Architecture and Urban Planning, we try to investigate it. But it's a kind of the sources are limited, and this is still not it's not the public part of the public information, and as I told you, to find any name about of architects of these buildings is quite a job. I think the key to those buildings is this anticipations of needs of and building clients' comfort, and the functionalism and new capitalism made by the state, and so-called gusto Polacco, which was the term invented by the designer of Liechtenstein Church, the biggest church in Europe, merged in one in this image of the new, completely new institution. We try to refresh it, and then the architecture. This architecture is so bad that it makes it consistent and coherent, and it happened unintentionally. So this is shocking that in global scale it could happen, because it was never thought to be like that. It was just several different investments made across the country, and investigating these circumstances and decisions in regions, and how the architects' freedom boundaries were shaped, because we don't know that yet, if they could, like in Czech, create with a lot of freedom, or that was somehow decisions, like aesthetic decisions made by Zeus. It was a starting point for further research. And one more thing is that in the interwar period, the Zeus architects team was really like the top of the time. Now these architects are completely invisible, and you will never find any of the Zeus building at the top architects from Poland nowadays. So I guess that's it.
Thank you very much, Kaspar. Questions? Maybe? I have only one. You said it's bad architecture in Poland, but it seems that there were a time when Zeus concentrated, maybe in the 80s and the 90s, before the beige period of Zeus, to put effort on to do this kind of brand through architecture. Had you the chance to meet anyone from Zeus, how it was directed, how they decided to do this?
Unfortunately, no. But they are sometimes appreciated already, because this one It will be refurbished soon, and the local association of architects. You will never find the author of this building on the internet. Don't even try. But they said it will be the architecture of the of this building will be preserved. So, but this is one of the oldest pomozuses, and also it's attached to the old town, so it makes some special case. But there are some interviews with the ZUS officials about the ZUS palaces phenomena, but it's only the only argumentation is about the, for instance, this headquarters of ZUS in Warsaw received a special prize for cost efficiency, and this is the argumentation that it could be even cheaper. So we'll never find anything about architecture. That's why we want to investigate this part after the churches towards the institutions.
Okay, if there's no question, I take the chance to move on because we sleep a little bit with our schedule. Good luck for your research to continue this. Thank you very much, Kasper.